G'day and welcome to LPEP, the music quiz show that understands that the Australian music scene is a little bit like Game of Thrones. There's a bit of piracy, there's some sex, but sometimes it can seem a little incestuous. With me as always, team captains Adam Knox and Beck Russo. Adam's first guest likes to wind down by deliberately upsetting himself through watching sad movies and depressing TV shows. It's LPEP's biggest fan, Dilruk Jayasinghah. Adam's second guest is a comedian working in a nut shop, or as my dad would say, he works with nuts and sells them too. It's comedian Tim Clark. Beck's first guest tonight says if she could assassinate one person, it'd be the producer of Rebecca Black's Friday. Well, joke's on you, Alex. It was written by two people, and one of them was Australian. And we apologise for that. From Animo, it's Alex Leahy. Beck's second guest tonight is from the band Scott Dracula, who got their name while watching an episode of Quantum Leap. And one of the bandmate's girlfriends mispronounced the name of lead actor Scott Bakula. It's a good thing they hadn't been watching Mad About You with Helen Hunt. It's Matthew Newman from Scott Dracula. Matt, it is a pleasure and a privilege to have you here. What's going on? What have you been up to?
Well, right now, we just recorded a bunch of stuff. And, well, not a bunch of stuff, so much as two things.
Two things. Two songs, two albums?
Two songs. We're going to try and put it out as a 7-inch. Right now, Dub's in Berlin, so I'm losing my fucking mind. Because we haven't been able to play a show in like a month, and I'm just kind of going nuts a little bit.
Why is he in Berlin?
Well, why not, man?
Is he just going on holiday, or is he cheating on you, or
no,
what's going
he's
on?
Not. He's
from ASIO?
Tim, pleasure to have you here. How are you going,
pleasure
man?
Pleasure to be here. Very good.
Yeah. Thank what you. Have you got some comedy festival stuff coming up?
Yes, Comedy Festival 2014. We'll be doing a split show with Sam Peterson, a very funny young man. Mm-hmm. And I'll be doing a quiz show myself, Lights, Camera, Faction, all about film trivia.
Why film?
I just know far too much about it to if I didn't do anything with it, it would just be a waste of my teenage years.
Favorite film then?
12 Angry Men.
12 Hungry Men?
Did you say?
12 Hungry Men. It's the comedic spin-off to 12 Angry Men.
All right, more of this stuff on Lights, Camera, Faction
Lights,
a little
Camera,
bit
Faction.
Later on.
I don't think a quiz show about pop culture is going to work, to be honest.
Sounds like
a really bad idea.
Only on television would it find a place.
Yeah.
Only in the loving arms of community television.
Thanks, guys.
Dil, pleasure to have you here. How are you going, man?
Very good. I'm very excited to be here. I do love the studio. This is a lot of effort that you guys have gone into, the records and stuff. Like, how long did that take to break each and individual one of those things?
I wasn't involved in that part of the show. I sit behind here and just
yeah,
talk
just the master
to the
going, go, plebs, go do my work.
The records weren't actually meant to be smashed. They just monumentally fucked it up.
Our first round tonight is Hits and Giggles. Each team will watch two artists' music videos and pick one as the answer to my question. Beck, Matthew, Alex, let's take a look at yours. Never knew that love could be this much fun. We can't go down. I just can't keep it down. I get lonely. I get lonely. You know I'm lonely. When we can't go down, I get lonely. I need to click the switch and show you how to hide. That was Sasquatch with I Get Lonely and Architecture in Helsinki with SKP. But which one of these two artists got their first big break from busking? Alex, you're pretty good mates with the gang from Sasquatch. What do you know about them?
We've played a whole lot of gigs together and they're really great guys. And I guess we've kind of come up in the same sort of scene in Melbourne. Mm. I know that they tear up Cherry Bar on a regular basis.
Mm. They do.
And they, like, fuck things up in a big way.
What do you mean?
It's like, if you've never seen a soul, like, it's like a soul band mosh pit sort of, like, I wouldn't be surprised if, like, one of those, like, Circle of Death things, like, started in, like,
a circle pit?
It's a circle pit, yeah. one of those things I started at like a soul gig at Cherry when they're playing because they're just like, they're that good.
I'm going to press you guys for an answer. What do we think? Sasquatch or Architecture in Helsinki started busking?
Well, I know that Architecture in Helsinki and Sasquatch are all Melbourne, they're both Melbourne acts. So, I mean, there's lots of busking going on in Melbourne. I mean, every single street there's somebody busking.
I don't think that that's accurate.
Really?
I've been on many streets where there's
nobody. Okay, not every street.
Your house, apparently, so don't you know?
You go home at the end of the day, there's somebody singing a fucking Wonderwall.
So they got
a fucking Wonderwall.
Jesus, every single one of them.
Little lion.
Like, I bust and I've never, yeah, jeez, oh.
There's one guy on the corner of Swanson and Burke who I walked down Swanson to go somewhere. He was playing Wonderwall on the way down. I walked back up Swanson Street 5-6 minutes later. He was playing Wonderwall again.
Yeah, Wonder Dan. Yeah.
He was back.
Wonder Dan, yeah.
That's his thing. He just plays Wonderwall.
I guess, I don't know. For the sake of this conversation, that's the one song he knows. He goes, time for this career to take off. The thing is that he's got a massive pedal board. Like, he's got, like, he has a decent, like, busking amp. He's got a decent pedal board for the specific purpose of achieving exactly the guitar effect.
All right, I'm going to press you guys. Architecture in Helsinki or Sasquatch started busking?
My gut is telling me that it is All Mate Sasquatch.
Sasquatch? I mean, that makes sense.
But I reckon they did it with a different lineup. Singer. I reckon they did it.
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense.
So I don't know if maybe they both busked and I'm going to stuff it up for all of us on a technicality.
Look, I mean,
I'd be so angry.
Let's just go with the mug.
I'd rotate for the rest of the show.
Don't you rotate away from me.
Let's go with Sasquatch. Let's do it.
Locking in?
Yeah.
You're right. Back in 2009, it was Sasquatch that was busking on the streets of Melbourne when they were invited by 3PBS's soul legend Vince Peach to join him at Cherry Bar's Thursday Soul Night. Lucky there is 9 of them, because normally when an old guy asks you out to a club, things go a little bit differently. Adam, Tim, Dill, let's take a look at yours. That was Cher with If I Could Turn Back Time and Ben Folds with Rock in the Suburbs. But which one of these artists tried to sell their key to the city of Adelaide?
I like that implies that they didn't manage to sell the key.
They didn't. They didn't manage to sell it.
No one wanted to buy it.
It got taken down because the city mayor of Adelaide was so upset.
Yeah, you would be.
This artist apologised, saying that it was all a mix-up.
Yeah, right. I was trying to sell my key to Sasquatch.
Yeah. What do we know about Ben Folds?
See, Cher's obviously got a lot more time on Ben Folds. Like, yeah, there's a whole era that she could have come and done all this nonsense.
Yeah.
I can't imagine Ben Folds wanting to sell his key. What would you get for selling the key? Hang on, what?
Do those keys really do anything?
No, it's purely a symbolic key. No, it's a skeleton key to every single lock in Adelaide.
It's a big key to open the gates to Adelaide.
I can't imagine somebody wanting to buy the key to Adelaide as well, because kind of the whole point of being given the key to a city, I'd imagine, it hasn't happened yet.
We'll see
how well this show goes.
But hey, Don, that's Tim's thing.
Sorry, you're infecting me with your cheesy finger guns.
which is not a medical condition.
The whole point of getting a key is that you do something good enough.
I do know that Ben Folds married an Australian woman.
There we go.
Is she from Adelaide? Is just marrying.
I think, hang on a second, he had a song called Adelaide.
If he's got a song called Adelaide and he's got a wife presumably from Adelaide.
Unless the song is really Adelaide. Any song about it.
To be fair, he has a song called Adelaide, but Cher has a song called Turn Back Time, and that's sort of what it's like if you go to Adelaide. But, okay, well, I'm happy to go with that. If Ben Folds has an Australian wife and has a song called Adelaide.
I think he does, yeah, yeah.
Then that sounds to me. Are you happy to go to Ben Folds?
I think it'd be stupid not to go to Ben Folds after all that. But let's go with Chet.
Lucky and Chet. No, it sounds like it's Ben Folds.
I think it's Ben Folds.
Lucky and Ben Folds.
Yep.
You're wrong. It was Cher that tried to sell her key to the city of Adelaide.
What a whore.
Cher's song went to number one in 1989 in Australia, but would have difficulty doing so nowadays because Australians really aren't that fond of foreigners on boats. Sadly, no points for Dill, Tim and Adam. Bad luck, guys. So after our first round, we have Adam's team behind on 0 points while Beck's team lead with 1 point. Very well done. Our next round is called Just Waiting for a Mate. Adam, Dill and Tim will be interrogating Beck, Alex and Matthew about a fact that belongs to one of them. Adam's team will get a point for choosing the correct person and Beck's team will get a point if they choose otherwise. All right, Officer Jayasinghe, Officer Knox, Officer Clark, was it Beck, Alex or Matthew that once on a dare from their boss appeared on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire and won a cash total of $0.
Beck.
Hang on.
Whoa.
If you were in a
you really mentalist that shit out.
As a member of the Australian Federal Police, you did not pass any sort of test.
I think that's kind of how they do it sometimes. Okay, well, we'll go with Matt first.
Yeah.
How long ago was this?
This is 2 years ago.
Two years ago. So it's like the quick fire version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire that they
CTV
have now.
CTV reiteration of it. What was it called? Hosting.
A quick fire version of it?
I have no idea, but it was a reissue on Canadian TV.
Oh, on Canadian TV.
Canadian. Yeah.
So what's $1 million worth there? Like 60
well,
bucks?
Well, still $1 million, but yeah.
60 million Canadian.
It'll get you, like, you know, get you Tim's coffee, and, you know, like, you can probably get, like, that old Honda in the yard, but, you know, it's like a bit of money. It's not bad.
Our Canadian audience has just gone straight up. Your dad has brought in
two backpackers from Calgary. Oh, my God, man.
Beck, I've known you for a while.
Yep.
I don't think you've ever been on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
How do you know?
Which boss dared you to go on it?
It was my boss from when I worked at a juice store. Oh, so this was like 3 years ago.
You did work at a juice store.
Yeah.
As if that's someone checks out.
Prominent juice store.
Alex, what was the question you asked?
Like the one that I bombed on.
Yep.
Yeah. It was about Shakespeare.
Okay.
Do you remember the answer Alex? That you didn't get?
I don't remember the answer, but it was about Macbeth. It was like the castle in Macbeth. Oh. And there were just like four very Scottish sounding words and I couldn't pick it.
I think Alex is full of shit. Okay. Okay. All right, we'll narrow it down to those two. Are you happy to eliminate Alex from the running?
I would say so, because if you lost on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, that question will probably be etched in your brain forever.
But again, but that literally will be the one time it'll ever be useful. It's not like you're going to go back. Even if you go back on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, they burn that question.
Yeah.
So I would actively unlearn things about Shakespeare to make room for other stuff.
I would etch it into my thigh.
That sounds like a legitimate question. There were different castles in Macbeth.
Was this the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire with Eddie Maguire?
Yeah.
I've seen him on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Like, he knows the questions beforehand, obviously, and he'll give a little bit of Shakespeare. I've seen him literally give a little bit of Shakespeare after a question and be like, oh, no, other stuff than, you know, football and stuff. And I've seen him...
Spot on impression, by the way.
Yeah, thanks.
Nailed it. It's as if he's right here with me. Lock it in, Eddie.
I think it could be any. I don't think Beck.
I put Alex back in the running now that I think about the question.
Because I knew you 3 years ago and you just weren't on, like, this is a little bit of insider knowledge, but I know that you weren't.
Did you think that maybe I was embarrassed that I didn't win any money so I didn't tell anyone?
No, you didn't.
You're okay with embarrassment. You're on this
show.
I'll say
this one thing, and hopefully it won't throw a cog in a works. We found out this information separately. The person didn't voluntarily give this information.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Beck
does seem like she does have shame, so she won't tell us.
I have so
no offense, guys. No offense, guys.
Did your question say Australia's who wants to be? No, okay. So I guess.
What province in Canada?
Oh, I have to go to Ontario for it. Okay. I was there at the time.
That is a province in Canada.
Yeah.
He's from Canada, so okay. It's not like it's
I'm from Canada generally. Oh, I'm just
was it snowing? Yes? Damn it.
Okay, we got one more question in us, I reckon. Matt, what was your question that you bombed on?
Metric conversion.
No, he's lying.
Converting from imperial to metric?
Yes, about converting from metric to imperial in distance.
Is that too easy?
He's that's just something he struggles with on a daily basis. Yeah. He's lying. All right, go back.
If you weren't miles away, I'd come at you right now.
Yeah, Beck, what was the question?
It was actually about Arnold Schwarzenegger and like what state he was the governor of. And now I know, I can never forget.
He bombed off that.
Yeah, come on, it was California.
That's interesting. You know what? That's a good point because Alex's question sounded too hard to be a first-round question.
It has to be below $1,000.
So I'm going to bring it down to Beck.
And Alex, last one, did you want to ask Alex one more question or are you going to lock Beck in?
Alex, how honest are you being right now?
I really don't think it's Beck.
Really? No. Okay.
She looks shifty.
Okay.
I think it's Beck with the candlestick in the pool room.
Dill, who do you think it is?
I'm going to go with Beck.
You think it's Beck?
Tim, who do you think it is?
I'm locking in Beck.
You think it's Beck? All right, I'll go with my team and I will say that Beck showed up. I know she didn't, but I'll go with my team and say Beck.
All right. Can I say that was my first guess?
Okay, we're locking in Beck. So, Matthew, Beck, Alex, which one of you was on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
I told you.
So it's 1 point for Alex, Beck, and Matthew. Very well done. Our next round is Top of the Props. Each team must link four artists with four other items in a certain category. Beck, Alex, Matthew. Let's take a look at your artists. Yep. Alex, down the end, you have...
We have Dougie from Temper Trap.
Yep.
We have Al Monfred from... Monfred. From Dick Diver. We have Celia.
Amy Finlay from Stonefield.
Celia,
yep. And last but not least...
Stonefield, and then we've got Cub Scouts.
Tim Nelson
from Cub Sport.
Okay, I need you to link those four artists to the undergraduate degree that they are studying. Matthew, you're holding toothbrushes, which represent dentistry.
Yes.
You also have a calculator, which represents accounting. Beck, you have a hairbrush, which represents popular music.
Oh, okay.
And last but not least, Alex, you have an undergraduate degree in politics.
Stabbing.
Oh, I get it.
All right.
Satire.
Okay. Nice.
So, if you can link these four artists to those four undergraduate degrees.
I reckon, so Bachelor of Popular Music, Amy from Stonefield, she's quite young still.
She
and
is.
She started young. I reckon...
She's got a great smile, though.
She's very pretty. I reckon she started young, so she's already found her career. So therefore, she maybe has done popular music, is what I'm thinking.
Yeah, so you can go to university for pop music?
Yeah, 100%. You can go to NMIT, Bachelor of Popular Music.
Back in the first ever major shows that Animo did were opening for Stonefield.
Uh-huh.
And
ooh.
It was Stonefield, King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard, and Animo, which is... weird.
It's a cool lineup.
Yeah, it is a sick lineup.
At the, yeah, and we did like a whole lot of shows with them and got to know the ladies quite well.
Mm. So do you know?
So you were very much correct.
Yeah.
All right.
I reckon.
But that's about all I can help with.
Okay, so we've got Amy Finlay in popular music.
Yeah.
How about Doogie Mandagi from Temper Trap?
Doogie.
Where's that guy with the thing?
Oh, yeah.
You know him?
Yeah, no, the guy with the thing.
Yeah, not him, no.
You mean Doogie?
Tim, or Dougie.
Yeah. He's the one who invented that dance, the Dougie.
I think we should just go with
him. I think that guy.
For what?
I just think about
him.
I'm going to press you guys. Tim Nelson from Cub Sport. What do you think?
I'm going to say accounting.
Oh, there you go.
I think he's cute.
All right.
Accountants are cute.
Dougie, we've got dentistry and we've got politics.
I really
left.
Reckon that Al Mumford is into politics.
He's
the coolest guy and I reckon...
and politics is pretty
and
cool.
And he gives a shit. I reckon he'll give a shit.
Yeah, he gives a shit. Let's do that.
Bam.
All right, and so we're going to go with Dougie
dentistry
and dentistry.
Dentistry goes to...
Dougie.
Inventor of the Dougie.
So we've got Dougie from the Temper Trap with dentistry.
Yep.
We've got Al Mumford from Dick Diver with politics. We've got Amy Finlay from Stonefield with popular music.
Yep.
And we've got Tim Nelson from Cub Sport with accounting.
Yes.
You had two correct.
That's good.
Tim Nelson from Cub Scouts has deferred his undergraduate degree in dentistry.
Al Monfort studied
an undergraduate degree in politics.
Yes.
Dougie Mandagi from Temper Trap studied accounting.
See, we didn't want to go with
that. Amy Finlay was a Bachelor of Popular Music from NMIT. So, very well done. 2 points, guys.
Good
on. All right, Adam, Dill, Tim, let's take a look at yours. Can you name your artists for me?
Mickey Mouse. Deadmau5.
Yep.
And yeah, the robot Daft from Punk. Tron.
Yes.
It's Daft Punk there.
Jean Valjean, UMI. And my boy Yeezy, Kanye West.
All right, so you have 4 items of associated merchandise. So, wow. Tim, you have beer and you also have condoms.
You're worried about what germs you'll catch from your beer, is it?
I practice safe drinking.
Adam, you have cat headphones.
Yeah, I guess.
Which is sort of the fluffy handcuffs were supposed to be the cat headphones.
Yeah, Dill just took them straight away.
Because they're so hot.
But my prop, this is my prop. I have sort of like sex paraphernalia.
Cat headphones, which is essentially headphones for cats. And last but not least, you have a white t-shirt.
Yep.
Kanye, what are we thinking for Kanye?
I think I know this one.
Really?
Because it was very recent and kind of controversial.
Okay.
Where he was selling just a plain white t-shirt online for $120.
Okay. Yeah, that's true.
And I put mine on layby.
It was called like a hip-hop t-shirt, but it was just a white t-shirt.
It was a plain white cotton t-shirt.
So we're thinking Kanye with the white t-shirt.
I definitely know Kanye with the t-shirt.
That's why Cher had to sell, she wanted one so much, she tried to sell a key to Adelaide. Okay, well then, you're right about that. That is with Kanye.
Definitely heard that.
You were
left with beer, kinky shit,
I feel like UMI with the beer, just because I want them to call it Brew-MI.
Right, that's great.
Also, Deadmau5 and Daft Punk, they can't drink beer because they wear helmets.
Mm-hmm. Also, they're, yes.
So,
and one of them's an animal.
But did one of them sell a type of beer? I know that Deadmau5...
Draft Punk.
Deadmau5
That's a point straight away. That's a point.
Draft Punk. Draft Punk.
So this must be things that they've branded themselves.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So I would say Deadmau5 got his name from not using condoms.
Oh, I know that there are Daft Punk condoms with Get Lucky written on them. They have...
Really?
Yeah. They sold...
Well, don't open that.
They sold Daft Punk branded condoms with Get Lucky on the side of it.
We're about to do sex ed.
The hit of the show.
Who's got the banana?
Are you about to check my prostate? Is that what's happening?
I'm getting the hands all lubey now.
This is completely...
I'm purely getting this out to put it on...
Just flop it over the...
Over Daft Punk, I reckon.
That's...
Oh, I see what you're trying to do.
There you go.
Okay. All right. UMI and Deadmau5 we've got left. UMI.
I feel like I'm a big fan of Brew-MI. Just going to say, I'm a big fan. But also, cat headphones, you said.
Yes.
I mean... That would go with...
The natural enemy of a mouse is a cat.
Yes.
So if you distract a cat by giving him some music to listen to...
Then you can boogie.
Yeah.
Okay. Which ones are we putting with which?
We'll chuck the cat headphones with Deadmau5. He's got some sort of...
I have a bad feeling about that.
Mouse and animal related. Plus he's got headphones as
okay.
well.
Okay, and we're chucking what with Daft Punk?
The condoms because they had the Get Lucky condoms.
With UMI, we're chucking...
The beer, because...
I feel like UMI is the one we know least about.
Yeah,
so we're just going with beer.
And last but not least, Kanye West with?
With the white shirt.
Okay, we're locking those in?
Yes.
Yes.
You had all 4 correct.
Yeah!
Our last round is the budget round because we spent all of our money this week on prophylactics. Each team will give me the next line of lyrics to the song. Adam, Dill, Tim, because you guys are in the lead, we'll start with you.
All right.
Your time starts now. There's gasoline in your heart.
And you should see a doctor.
I'm going to pass it over there.
There's fire in mine.
There's fire in mine. Gasoline Alpine. Up so early, feel so bright.
Didn't get much sleep last night.
Didn't get much sleep last night. Wish you well, Bernard Fanning. She's a woman. You know what I mean.
You got to listen to me.
You better listen to me. Woman, wolf, mother. How's
that?
How's that, Sherbet? Won't you take me to...
A gay town.
Funky town. Pseudo echo. Nothing's fine. I'm torn. I'm all out of faith.
This is how I feel.
This is how I feel, torn Natalie and Brilliant. So I walked under a bus, I got hit by a train.
Keep falling in love, which is kind of the same.
Absolutely everybody.
Absolutely everybody.
Vanessa Amorosi! Alex, Beck, Matthew, you need 8 to draw. Your time starts now. Parlez-vous français?
Woo!
Oui.
Parlez-vous français, art versus science. Baby, is this how you feel?
I want to know.
Is this how you feel? The preachers. Because I feel like I'm walking on fire when we're talking. It's...
Walking on fire.
Problem.
Smoke coming out of my head. I got burned the bamboos.
That's it.
Sweet
disposition.
Sweet disposition, temper trap. It's a hard day for being lonely.
And a sad way for you to go.
And a sad way for you to go this time. Animo, it's true what they say about us. We're bad for business, baby.
No good punks.
No good punks, crazy go nuts, Scott Dracula. I've lost my mind and I know why, but it's, yep.
Not that simple.
Not that simple. Animo. Don't you come around here, man, I'm warning ya.
No, is that your
song? Yeah, my whole crew's wild. We ain't scared none of you.
Ain't scared Scott Dracula.
Hey, I should get those faster.
And at the end of our final round, we have Beck's team on an amazing 13 points, but Adam's team ahead with 14 points. A huge thank you to Alex from Adamo, Matthew from Scott Dracula, Tim and Dill. You've been watching LPEP. I've been Mike O'Donoghue. Have a good one.